Hi, my name is Naomi Fraga, and I'm the Director of Conservation Programs here at California Botanic Garden. The garden is involved in a diversity of conservation activities, and it's really central to the work that we do here. We perform in-situ conservation, which is also called on-site conservation, in the form of botanical surveys, research, and restoration. We also are very involved in ex-situ conservation or off-site conservation, where we bring materials from wild populations to the garden to include in our diversity of collections. And that might include herbarium specimen collections, seed collections, or live material to be propagated for our living collection. Doing this kind of conservation work is really important in California because we have a high diversity of plants that are of conservation concern. Over a third of the plants native to our state only occur in California and nowhere else in the world. And over 2,300 plants in California are considered rare, threatened, or endangered. So it's really important that we take action to conserve this great diversity of native plants. Through our living collection, we grow a great number of species that people can learn and appreciate on our garden grounds. And one of the species you'll learn about today is the Santa Lucia Fir, also known as Abies bracteata, which we collected seeds from the wild and now have it growing in our living collection.
Welcome to the California Seed Bank. I'm Cheryl Berker and I'm the manager here. So Abies bracteata is a rare fir tree that occurs in the Santa Lucia Mountains off the central coast of California. And due to its rarity and threats from things like wildfire, we really wanted to conserve this species outside of its natural habitat. We wanted to make a conservation seed collection to store here in the freezers. And we also wanted to have individuals growing in the garden, you know, in our living collection, in case something happens to those populations in the wild. But this was no easy feat. There's a lot of challenges associated with making a seed collection of this species. First of all, it's a mass seeder, meaning it'll only produce a good crop of seeds once in every couple of years when conditions are right. There's a lot of seed predation, particularly by this calcid wasp. The plants grow on really rugged terrain, really steep hillsides, so the plants are really hard to access. And on top of that, the seeds are only produced in cones at the very tops of these tall spindly trees. So it's essentially the opposite of low-hanging fruit. It took us 4 years of scouting and seed collection attempts before we finally made a seed collection. We had to hire a tree climber, haul all of his gear out to these populations, and then he had to climb the trees. He couldn't even get to the top of the trees because the tops are too flimsy. So what he wound up doing is climbing as high as he could and then shaking the tree so that the cones would release their seeds. And then my colleague and I were running around trying to catch falling seeds. It was very silly. There was a lot of improvising, but we did make a small seed collection. Those seeds are now in storage here. So in the future, if something happens to that population in the wild, we could pull seeds from the freezers and reintroduce the plant to the wild. Before storing the seeds in the freezers, we took a sample of those seeds for a germination test so we could see how viable the seeds are. We wanted to make sure we knew how to grow the plant from seed to inform any future restoration efforts. And as a byproduct, we wound up with little seedlings that we then grew up and planted in the garden.
Hi, I'm Evan Green. I'm a horticulturist here at California Botanic Garden. We're here now in our conservation grove of Abies bracteata, the Santa Lucia fir, which you can see here in this cage. So conservation groves like this one are an important method of ex-situ conservation that can be complementary to seed banking. So this is especially useful for plants that are hard to seed bank. For example, a lot of trees like oaks, their seeds don't store very well. They don't freeze or dry very well. And so it's helpful to conserve them as collections of living plants in a garden as opposed to in a seed bank. So these trees here have been a real big challenge to grow here in Claremont outside of their natural range. They are used to things being a lot cooler. So here the intense heat and dryness makes it tricky to grow them. So we use this shade cloth to protect them from the hottest sun during the summer. And we give them a lot of extra water. And you can see this plant is about 4 years old. It's been in the ground for 2 years. So they're very, very slow growing. So yeah, they're a challenge to get established. This grove you see here, we planted 12 2 years ago. We're down to about 7. Sometimes we lose them. We're not even exactly sure why. Often it's during periods of intense heat, like heat waves. But yeah, with each plant we lose, hopefully we learn something about what they do like. And so there just has to be, with rare plants like this, often there's a lot of trial and error in terms of growing them in the garden and trying to figure out what they like. So ideally in the future, our hope for the future is that we can get these trees to grow to their to a height where they can produce seed and produce seed consistently. And that seed would provide a backup to the seed stored in the seed bank, and could also provide seed for future reintroduction efforts with the species into the wild. And then therefore greater protection against extinction.
Before leaving, we just want to emphasize that the conservation work for Abies bracteata is not yet done. And additionally, this is just one of many rare and endangered California native species. And protecting these guys in the wild and through ex-situ means like seed banking and through conservation groves is now more important than ever in the face of increasing threats like wildfires and climate change. And luckily, we're not alone in this endeavor. We work with a wide variety of partners, other botanic institutions, conservation organizations, government agencies that are working every day to protect species from extinction.